We are waiting on the children that are getting ready in the back, but we will let them come in as we get started. Why don't you go ahead and play a little bit more? And family alike. I'm just going to address the elephant in the room. No, I did not have surgery yet. I was too ill for them to be able to do surgery for me, so it got rescheduled, but that means I am blessed to be here with you all today, which is such a great thing. I was so looking forward to it. So welcome, everyone. Glad to have you here. Let's just take a minute, take a deep breath, invite God's welcoming presence with us. And then we will have the choir begin with a song.
Thank you.
called to celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ, the light of the world. Rejoice, for God is with us. Emmanuel.
In the darkness of our troubles shines God's holy light.
Thus, there is reason to hope, to love, to laugh, to live.
God is truly with us. We are not alone. Thanks be to God.
We will continue with our first hymn, O Come All Ye Faithful.
Continue with the lighting of the Advent wreath. God of love, you have come among us in the birth of Jesus Christ, the Savior of the world.
You have changed the darkness of sin and death to the resurrection and joy of Easter morning.
You are the everlasting life that can change all our hopes and fears.
Come in the quiet candlelight of this worship and meet us here personally.
All creation is filled with joyful celebration at the birth of Christ. Amen.
Thank you.
Is from Isaiah, the 9th chapter. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation, have increased its joy. They rejoice before you with joy at the harvest. People exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For a child has been born for us, son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named a wonderful counselor, mighty God, everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually. There shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onwards and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord. We will continue with some special music.
The gospel reading today is from the second chapter of Luke. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them at the inn. The word of the Lord. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying,
Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors.
When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us. So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in a manger. And they made known what had been told to them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what had the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all of these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told to them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Next hymn.
Wondrous us, mysterious God, mighty God, wonderful counselor. We thank you that we are able to express our freedoms, to express our joy for your presence in our lives. Bless us now as we seek to meditate and apply some of the gospel message, the word message, to our faith journeys. In Jesus' strong name, amen. Well, grace and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. A young married couple from Wisconsin was now living in Minnesota, and they would come back for more than a weekend. And so they were getting ready to come over to Wisconsin, and car was in the driveway. They had made arrangements with the post office to stop the mail. They had talked with the neighbor to keep an eye on the house, and then to come in and to feed the dog and walk the dog. They also now are in the process of packing everything in their car, their many gifts for aunts and uncles, their parents, their nieces, and nephews, etc. They were packing those babies in, and they brought out their suitcases and, you know, the folding, hanging type stuff that you do with your clothes. They got that all in, and they're hopping in, and the husband began backing up, and all of a sudden, the wife gasped, "We forgot the baby!" One of the challenges that there are those critics who say that it's so easy nowadays to forget that the Christmas is about who? About Christ, the baby child. I'm just glad that there is many of you sitting here today, tonight, about here who want to focus on the baby child. Because the Christ child has relevance. In the cartoon that I found a while back, I can't remember, the family circus, it said three young boys came to a manger scene bearing gifts. Two of them bore the same traditional kind of stuff, gold and frankincense. The third was noticed in the cartoon was the young guy brought in a large box of disposable diapers. And the guess is that the creator of the cartoon was in a humorous way trying to remind people that the baby Christ has relevance to a world in need. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I'm bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is the Messiah, the Lord." Now, maybe some of you heard this, but someone once wrote, "If our greatest need had been for information, God would have sent us an educator. If our greatest need had been technology, God would have sent us a scientist. If our greatest need had been for money, God would have sent us an economist. If our greatest need had been pleasure, God would have sent us an entertainer. But our greatest need was forgiveness. So God sent us a Savior." Christmas is about God meeting human need in relevant ways that we could all talk about. What might you be in need of saving from recently? Since my background, again, is in counseling and family therapy and working for those in social services for a juncture, I resonate with this article from the United Methodist Help website. It's an article that says this, the opening title, "Help! My family stresses me out at Christmas." Let's see if you identify. Quote, I'm going to read the whole thing. "You've been to see your therapist for a booster session. You've refilled your prescriptions for antidepressants. You've practiced your positive affirmations. You're feeling good. You're feeling strong. There's no doubt in your mind that this year you can handle the holidays with your family. This time definitely will be different, you tell yourself. Yeah, right, the author says. Visiting family over the holidays for many means walking a proverbial tightrope of emotions. Despite your best efforts to prepare yourself for the worst in what is supposed to be the best of times, it all falls apart the minute the past creeps into the present. Grandma Minnie mentions you look like you've gained a few pounds. Your sister teases you about your non-existent love life. Your liberal brother angrily debates politics with your conservative father. Mom is so busy people-pleasing, she doesn't even ask you about your promotion at work. Before you can say, ho, 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 you're back to being 15 years old again and feeling hurt, resentful, or furious. And all the years of expensive therapy disappear along with the expectations of Kodak moments, hopes for a holly jolly Christmas. Well, guess what? The author says, it's reality check time. Quote, people too often think that they'll come home for the holidays and it will be different, says Amy Birchall, director of St. Luke's Center for Counseling and Life Enrichment. They think this year we'll all get along, or I'll see my family again, and it will be a great thing. But they don't take it into account. They don't take into account that they can't undo perhaps years of dysfunctional or strained relationship in just one holiday weekend. If you go back with different behaviors and a different outlook, she added, you have a chance of making things different and having a pleasant time. But if you go back and replay those family roles that you were always in, then it's going to blow up again, especially if you've changed, but others haven't. Feeling like a teen again. Then she adds this. Jack, United Methodist pastor, knows the right things to say and to do when it comes to encouraging and advising others dealing with holiday stress, especially managing family dynamics. But when he makes a five-hour trip home to celebrate Christmas with his parents, grandparents, and brothers, he reverts to being the middle child who bickers with his younger brother, argues with his father, and absorbs the stresses between his parents and grandparents. When I'm away from home, he says, I'm a capable 30-year-old United Methodist minister that people look up to. I can usually hold it together and keep perspective in life's challenges, but when I go home, I become someone trapped by the same challenges that I'm supposed to be able to overcome in the ministry. I become the teenage son again. Maybe I've shared some of my story. I have six sisters. My dad was an alcoholic who ran away from home when I was age 4 and died after running away from home. Alcoholism and high blood pressure. Why do I want to become interested in psychotherapy and pastoral counseling? Our family of origin so often impel us in positive ways and not so positive some ways. Janice can relate. She too becomes a different person with her family than she is in the pulpit. I always feel like I have to tread very lightly. I think I have to watch what I say and what I do, and most of the time, I can't be myself. There's a lot of pressure not to do anything that will upset anyone. It reminds me of growing up. Now when she visits family at Christmas, Janice ends up wanting to follow the example of Dorothy and the Wizard of Oz. She wishes that she could click her heels 3 times and disappear to go home. And then they ask these haunting questions. So why do we do it? Why do we still buy presents? Why do we take all the energy to go home? Why do we seem to be gluttons for punishment? But another faith perspective question is, well, why? And a response? Because we want and we need the emotional closeness of family. We want and need to experience, hopefully, forgiveness for stressors from the past or bad moments. We want and we need to feel joyful about our family, that we've moved along. That we've moved along in our family of origin history. In other words, once again, Christ is relevant for our lives because we have so many needs that we need to overcome, to be reinforced in, to be empowered to work through, and to express the love that we know that Christ has for us. We should also know that there's tons of examples of Scripture that shows the dysfunction of the family, even the great heroes of the faith. Joseph and his brothers, what did they try to do? Because they were jealous of him, to get rid of him, to kill him. Cain and Abel, and it goes on, and it even goes into the New Testament when Paul talks about the various challenges of the churches and what's going on, and he has to instruct them and to deal with the things that are there, that are present in the church family. Quite possibly there's a higher calling at Christmas, and we all know what it is. We know and we hear and we claim that God is present in our family through the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, and God's Word. And again, isn't it that Christmas calls us to act like Wally? And I'll close with this. Wally is big for his age. He's 7 years old. And a number of people wondered what his role the teacher would give him for the annual Christmas play, especially considering the fact that sometimes Wally seemed to be a slow learner. What kind of responsibilities would they give him so that he could catch on quick enough? Perhaps he could pull the curtain for people for the play. And a whole lot of people were surprised that the teacher gave him the innkeeper position. Wally seemed delighted. He knew that there's only one phrase, one sentence that he had to say, and he seemed to be getting on top of it quite easy. There's no room in the inn. Had it down pat. The night of the presentation, parents had filled in, relatives, every seat in the auditorium was filled, and children began singing, "O Come, All Ye Faithful." The lights dimmed. Hush came over the audience. Curtain open. Scene one. Mary and Joseph enter the stage and walk up to the innkeeper and says, "Please, sir, my wife is not well. Could we have a room for the night?" Wally was ready for his line. And he began, "There is," and he seemed to freeze. He wet his mouth, took a gulp of air, and he couldn't go much farther. He tried again, "There is," and it was very awkward. And so poor Joseph, the character, started to go, "Well, okay, well, we can try over here." But Wally, the innkeeper, says, "Stop. Stop. There's room in my house. Come on home and stay with us, with me and my family." And there was this big, whew, and thank you, Wally. It seems to me that time and time again, when we hear the word, particularly the Christmas story, is that God is calling us to be humble about the need that we have yet to be saved in our personal lives, in our relationships, which sometimes still has their stressors, and we hope and wish it would change. Christmas voice, it seems to me, always calls us to humble ourselves and say, God is with us in the person of Christ through the work of his Holy Spirit and his word. And he's calling us home always to take him home and recognize that the Spirit and the Word and Christ is in our homes. And be blessed and live with joy and confidence for the future. Happy New Year. Merry Christmas. Amen.
how you follow that up. Thank you. That was beautiful. All right, we will continue with the prayers of the church. Your response will be, we give you thanks and praise. Trusting in God's good news of great joy for all people, we offer our prayers for ourselves, our neighbors, and the world God loves. Glory to you, God, for the song of the angels proclaiming to the world Christ's holy birth. Give your church a joyful song to sing, that we bring the good news of peace and salvation to all people. God of hope, we give you thanks and praise. Glory to you, God, for the stars that shine in the depth of the night. Provoke awe in our hearts at the expansive mystery of the cosmos. Open us to find beauty in the clear darkness of night and in the first glimmers of dawn. God of hope,
we give you thanks and praise.
Glory to you, God, for the child born to us who establishes a kingdom of justice and righteousness. Make beautiful the work of peacemakers, community organizers, and advocates who work to ensure that all people flourish in safety and dignity. God of hope,
we give you thanks and praise.
Glory to you, God, for Mary's loving care. Lead us to tend to one another in time of need. Share the comfort of your presence with all people tonight who are alone or separated from the loved ones due to estrangement, incarceration, or illness, especially those we name out loud or in our hearts at this time. God of hope,
we give you thanks and praise.
Glory to you, God, for the faithfulness of the shepherds in their vocation. Grant rest to any who feel exhausted from their work during this season, especially retail and restaurant workers, church musicians, administrative staff, and clergy, organizers of charitable giving events, and service workers doing essential tasks. God of hope,
we give you thanks and praise.
Glory to you, God, for the multitude of the heavenly hosts. We rejoice in the zeal of all your saints who have witnessed the appearing of your grace and who revealed to us your salvation for all. God of hope,
we give you thanks.
Abide with us, O God of mercy, and receive our prayers according to your abundant grace. Amen. We will continue with our offering and our offering hymn. Please stand as you are able.
Thank you.
Good and loving God, we rejoice in the birth of Jesus, who came to bring the riches of your grace. As you have blessed with your gifts, let them be blessing for others. In Jesus' name, amen.
God with us.
Amen.
You may be seated. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory, now and forever. Amen.
Come to the banquet, for all is ready and all are welcome. The ushers will guide you today. We will be doing it as a continuous line up front. So please just wait for your usher to guide you.
Body of Christ for you. Body of Christ for you. Body of Christ for you. Body of Christ given for you. Body of Christ given for you.
Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen and preserve you in eternal life. Amen.
We continue with the candle lighting. Light is a prominent theme in the text, Songs and Symbols of Christmas Eve. John Rutter's Candlelight Carol captures the beauty of different kinds of light that may have been visible at Jesus' birth. Candlelight, angel light, firelight, and star glow shine on his candle till breaking of dawn. Jesus is the light of the world. As his followers, we are called to receive his light and carry him into the darkness of today. For all those who have candles, the person who has a lit candle, please keep it up, and the others will light from that person. And if anyone's near a window wants to crack it, that would be a good idea.
Start singing. They are going to sing Piece by Piece once through, then we will go right into Silent Night. They will then come in on verse 3 with Piece by Piece in Peace, but we will continue to sing verse 3 along with them.
The Lord bless you and keep you. God's wisdom guide you. God's grace strengthen you. Amen. For those able, please rise.
Today. So thank you, Pastor Dean. Appreciate it. Let's also thank all of our beautiful musicians and singers today. It was beautiful. Thank you so much. You made our day special. And finally, let's thank the children who were able to come up here and improvise. Yeah, good job. Yes. All right. Well, thank you all. Go in peace. Share the good news of God's light and love in Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Children, also on your way out, there are bags in the back for you to take home with you. Thank you. All right, I'm going to go out.
Oh, maybe Janet, you can take a picture.
Oh, I thought you had an astronaut.
Janet. Oh, could you do a picture?